Well, Zipcar is an example of what's considered to be the first wave of collaborative consumption. And this first wave of collaborative consumption, businesses managed the excess capacity that was available and provided services to meet the need that that capacity is used for. Other examples of first wave collaborative consumption include companies like Netflix. For example, Netflix said, well, why in the world would you buy a DVD if you're only going to watch it one time? That is, in some sense, an enormous excess capacity of DVD-ness that if you were to instead just borrow that DVD, you could share it with other people and you would get a lot more value from using many, many different DVDs. And Netflix built their business model, their original business model, out of doing that by sending and receiving the DVDs through the mail. Use it briefly and then return it. More recently, the idea of co-working spaces has emerged. Co-working is asks the question, why should you rent an office for your business if you're only there for a small amount of time? Now, this is not true for everyone, but for some people like real estate agents who are in their offices relatively small amounts of time and are out on the road doing sales and presentations and other things most of the time, it doesn't really make a lot of economic sense for them to rent a complete office suite. So instead of using that, what they do is they use a co-working space. They just rent an office or a cubicle for a period of time and the associated services that come with it, lighting, reception, meeting rooms, kitchens, things like that. And they just use it when they need it. And when they're not using it, they clear up their space and they leave and someone else can use that space for a period of time. That's the idea of co-working. You can find co-working places all over California. Some of them have kind of a very traditional business vibe. Some of them have a very kind of creative hipster sort of vibe to them. Well, these services are fundamentally enabled by recent technology. It's difficult to imagine a service like Zipcar even being possible without location-enabled smartphones and GPS trackers and cellular communication widely and ubiquitously available. The process of registering and reserving and paying for these services in real time must be very efficient and effective for this kind of a business to even be possible. If co-working, Netflix, and Zipcar are examples of the first wave of collaborative consumption, the second phase of collaborative consumption is built on these foundations but does something slightly different. The second phase no longer involves companies managing the inventory, and instead what the companies do is they manage a marketplace. It was at this point that collaborative consumption started becoming a thing that people thought about and that it took off. In this phase of the model, individuals manage their own excess capacity, but they use the business as a service to connect to other consumers who would like to use that capacity. So sometimes it's called consumer to consumer or peer-to-peer collaborative consumption. So sort of well-known examples of this are Airbnb. You may be familiar with Airbnb. This service allows people to rent out their living quarters at various levels of granularity, meaning that if you have an extra couch, you can rent out that couch as a place for someone to stay for a small amount of money. If you have an extra room in your home, you can rent out that extra room for short or medium durations. Or if you have an extra house, not everyone does, but if you have an extra house, you can use Airbnb to rent out that home, typically in a vacation style rental as opposed to a long-term rental. So compare Airbnb to a hotel chain like Marriott. Marriott also lets you rent out living quarters. Typically, in the granularity of room, Marriott lets you get a hotel room. This is like renting out a room. But Marriott manages the inventory. They have a hotel, a business, a building in which their capacity exists, the hotel rooms, and they rent them out and they take care of that inventory. They own the buildings, they maintain them, they get to pick the wallpaper. In contrast, in Airbnb, the individual owners put their locations on the listings, and then Airbnb connects them with the people who can pick what they want from all the different people who are offering their locations as places to stay. Owners can make extra money, and typically travelers can stay places cheaper than what they might pay at a hotel or some other living arrangement. And there tends to be a more personal connection in the Airbnb rentals and the consumers, it's more personal. People, the landlords and the boarders get to know each other. But the inventory is maintained by the people who are renting out the couch and the room and the extra homes. They maintain the inventory. Airbnb never deals with the inventory themselves the way Marriott manages the inventory. So it turns out that there are tons and tons and tons of services that have grown up around this concept. For example, there is this concept applied to fashion. The company Poshmark enables people to buy and sell fashion online. And Snob Swap is an example of a company that does the same thing for high-end designer fashion. So you have some high-end designer fashion, someone would like to use it, you can rent it to them for a period of time or trade it for something that they might have. Do you have a driveway that you don't use? Well, Parking Panda will allow you to rent out your driveway for parking. Maybe you happen to live near a university or near a commuter rail station, or maybe you live somewhere near a stadium and you only and there's only limited demand for that your driveway, but you're not using it, you might as well rent it out. Parking Panda will allow you to manage your excess inventory and connect you with consumers. Do you have a baby and you're done with your baby clothes? Well, ThredUp is a company that lets you exchange your clothes with families that have older kids. It's kind of the collaborative consumption economy for hand-me-downs, except it's a trade. Would you like to be Netflix, but not have Netflix manage the inventory? Would you like to manage your own inventory? Well, you can trade DVDs, you can trade CDs, you can rent out video games, you can rent out books in the same way that Netflix does, but you manage your own inventory at a website called swaptree.com. Would you like to be Zipcar? You can manage your own inventory. If you want to rent it out just like Zipcar does, but own the car, then there's a company called Relay Rides that'll help connect you with consumers that would like to rent out your car in a short term. Do you have an extra car, but you're not comfortable letting someone else drive it? Well, there are organizations like Uber and Lyft that will let you act as the driver for someone else so that you can rent out your excess capacity in your vehicle, but also your excess capacity in your time as a driver for moving someone else around. And Uber and Lyft won't maintain that capacity, but they'll connect you with consumers. Do you have a backyard that you're not using? Would you like to let someone else use it for gardening? Well, there's an organization called Landshare that's very popular in the UK that allows people that have backyards that they're not particularly interested in maintaining or farming or gardening. And Landshare will connect one person's backyard with someone else who would like to have a small garden patch to maintain and to enjoy. And Landshare will allow those two kinds of people to connect. All kinds of different models and remixing of this idea of becoming a marketplace for connecting excess capacity that an individual controls and maintains with people who would like to use that capacity for a short amount of time. Sometimes there's money involved, sometimes it's a trade, sometimes it's just the creation of a community so that people can enjoy the capacity together.